Who could have pictured this, huh? I mean, I always knew you were something special, but this? This is next level. Only a handful of fighters have become double champs in the UFC. Some very rare company. And time. Good. All right, at the end of the night, though, remember, it's just a fight. Stay focused on the task at hand. We can worry about finding more trophy space in the morning. All right, let's go. Good.
Well, what a moment we have got in front of us tonight. And for this fighter, one win away from UFC immortality. He became a UFC champion in one division. And tonight, he will try to become a simultaneous two-division UFC champion. Absolutely incredible. What can be accomplished in front of our eyes tonight? He is the reigning, defending, undisputed UFC welterweight champion in a division full of killers. He has remained the hunted at 170 pounds. Now, unquestionably staring at his toughest challenger to date, can he go back home as the champion? If he can, another chapter to one of the greatest welterweight legacies the Octagon has ever seen. Our tale of the tape for this welterweight championship fight. More than 5 years apart, some differences in height and reach as well. To get us started, here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge, Eve Loving. And now, this is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the MGM Grand Garden Arena in Las Vegas, it's time! 5 rounds for the undisputed UFC welterweight championship of the world. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner, this man is a boxer, holding a professional record of 29 wins, 2 losses. He stands 5 feet 9 inches tall, weighing in at 170 pounds, fighting out of Coconut Creek, Florida, presenting the challenger, Dustin the Diamond Poirier. And now introducing the champion, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a mixed martial artist, holding a professional record of 22 wins, 4 losses. He stands 6 feet 1 inch tall, weighing in at 170 pounds. Presenting the reigning, defending, undisputed UFC welterweight champion of the world, Shavkat Nomad Rachmanov.
UFC belt on the line, guys. Protect yourself at all time. Obey my command at all time. If you want to touch love, do it now. Go back to your corner.
You ready?
All right, let's see if he can get off to a good start here tonight as he tries to become a simultaneous two-division UFC champion. This is some rarefied air that has not been occupied by too many fighters. He has prioritized getting off to a good start here tonight against a naturally bigger man. Let's see how it plays out. single collar tie here. Clark going for the early takedown. He gets it. So no surprise he wanted to get this fight to the ground. And that is certainly a good sign for him moving forward in this fight.
He felt as if he had a massive advantage in the grappling and wrestling. He was a
quick entry here.
Nice single leg entry. Rotates ahead outside to a high crotch. Oh! Nice big takedown. What a technique. What a takedown. Great high impact skill.
You could feel the canvas reverberating here at the broadcast.
I mean, right there. Boom, 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 boom. It's like me running anywhere, John.
Bottom fighter trying to control posture, unable to do so.
And now he's in a lot of danger. He's got to grab that head or he's going to get blasted.
All right, half guard position for him here, and I can hear Dominic Cruz in the back of my head just screaming about underhooks somewhere.
Yeah,
somewhere.
He loved, I mean, but he's right, right? He's so right in terms of if you're on your back in the half guard, one thing you can't be is flat on your back. You need to be up on an elbow.
Right.
You need to be half on the side, and you need to control the far side underhook. It is a battle for underhook when you're fighting in the half guard position on the mat.
Oh, now trying to isolate an arm, DC.
He needs to move his hips back to cover. He cannot allow him on that angle. He's going to attack arm bar here.
Posturing up now.
Now he's okay. Now he can escape.
Under 2 minutes in the first round. Seconds remain in the round. Man, this is some serious ground and pound here, DC. He's not just staying busy for the sake. Oh, looks like he's transitioning to an armbar.
You cannot stay in the guard of these great jiu-jitsu guys. Attack an armbar.
So we cross the 30-second mark in our opening round. To choose over those previous 5 minutes, DC, a lot of good work on the ground.
You knew, John, going into the fight, that if he was able to get this fight to the floor, he would have the most success, and you saw it in that exchange. He was able to get posture, land some really good ground and pound as the round came to an end.
All right, here we go with our next round. And DC, you've spoken a lot about ground and pound skills and how it's a little bit of a lost art in modern day mixed martial arts. Certainly not for this one.
No, and he does it the old school way, right? Now, nowadays, you push a guy to the side of the octagon, they use it as a barrier to get up.
Right.
Not with this guy. He stuffs your head in the corner, he gains his posture, and he just starts dropping hammers until eventually you're gonna turn to your knees, he'll take your neck and choke you, or he'll just put you back down. It's crazy to watch him dictate his opponent's actions with his power from this position. Not many guys can generate that type of power. You gotta go back to guys like Mark Munoz. They used to call him the Filipino smack.
Poirier's got his head looking for a guillotine.
He's attacking guillotine.
Oh, we're getting a finish here. Oh, what a beautiful counter to the guillotine there. Gets side mount, and now maybe the Von Flute choke will be there. Ovin St. Preux has got to like that transition there. Is really remarkable to watch. Trying to guard pass here, not today.
No, it ain't happening. Good job understanding the transitions.
Poirier's got his head looking for a guillotine choke.
Oh, he's stuck in a guillotine. Why is he not recognizing this right now? He's got to recognize.
Oh, what a beautiful, seamless transition to side mount as he counters the guillotine. Might be able to sink in a Von Flute choke here. Somehow stays in the fight. All right into side control here, DC. Biggest difference between half guard and side control.
Well, side control to me feels like a little bit less control because now my legs aren't really doing anything anymore. Now I'm controlling you with my upper body. So I've got to be very, very aware. It's still advantageous, but it just seems a little more free-flowing than having something like a half guard.
All right, he's trying to control posture here. Now trying to hip escape.
He's just trying to move out of this position off the bottom.
Close guard. Oh, trying to pass here, but Dikembe Mutombo style, he gets denied.
Blocked! Great job blocking that pass by the bottom fighter.
Well, he's really starting to land a high number of strikes here in the second round. No denying that he has taken the...
He's gonna try to take him down. There you go.
Oh, he slams him to the ground. All right, so inside the open guard of his opponent, you gotta be careful playing around for too long here on the ground with this guy. All right, so he postures up here and now figures to rain down some ground strikes.
Yeah, the ground and pound will be a plenty from this position.
All right, that's the end of round number two. All right, let us now look back at some of the highlights from that round, and there just aren't that many guys on this roster that can keep up this offensive wrestling pace over 15 or 25 minutes.
But he's one of those guys. He is one of those guys that's able to continuously take you down, even if you get up over and over. He has this ability to maintain that pace and pressure that he can wear his opponents down. That's why you see him get so many finishes as the fight progresses. Nice job of hiding that head kick.
Now a takedown attempt. It is not there, and not a ton behind it. Switching stances here. Well, really using his reach advantage there with that punch, DC. Oh, working hard here against the fence. We'll see if he can get the takedown. This is with that punch. Single collar tie there. Now goes in and secures the takedown. Oh, reversal here, DC.
What a way to switch the position. Fantastic movement by the bottom fighter.
All right, so you gotta be careful playing on the ground with this guy. You don't want to mess around for too long. All right, working inside his opponent's guard here.
You cannot sit in these jiu-jitsu guys' guard. And you can't have one arm in, one arm out. Guys will start throwing up legs, chasing triangles.
Just reached the midway point of the fight. Oh, nice job using his strength there to posture up. We'll see what he can do now.
He's gonna start looking to land big shots from the top.
Well, both fighters pretty comfortable on the ground, DC, but you gotta be very careful hanging out here for too long if you're his opponent. All right, he's very comfortable fighting off his back, DC. Now looks like he's trying to hip escape.
Yeah, he's trying to hip escape or maybe look for a Kimura here.
Poirier's right back to the full mount. Fighter trying to control posture, unable to do so.
And now he's in a lot of danger. He's got to grab that head or he's going to get blasted.
Well, anytime you are in a ground fighting situation with this fighter, you're potentially playing with fire. Working off of his back here, looks like he may try to hip escape. Well, you see all the grappling repetitions here. Just beautiful movement, seamless transitions on the ground.
Over and over, these guys are doing things that you see in every jiu-jitsu gym around the country.
Keeping busy here off of his back. Nice offense from the bottom. Strong bottom work here, staying busy. Poirier's back in half guard. He's very comfortable here. All right, let's now look back at some of the action from that round. He went headhunting, landed, nearly got the finish, too.
A lot of coaches tell you don't headhunt. In this case, he's been headhunting, and he landed a big enough shot to truly put his opponent on notice. Way to hide that leg kick.
Oh, flush knee to the body. He's got the length advantage in this fight and certainly made it count in that exchange. Oh, massive head kick there. We'll see if he can finish. Now goes in and secures the takedown. Oh, and he gets the takedown here. We'll see what he can do with it. These are some excellent ground and pound strikes here, DC. There's an efficiency with which he operates in these situations.
He knows exactly when to throw, exactly when to hold, and it's allowing him to really control the grappling aspect of the fight.
There's a song there, right? Know when to hold him,
know when to hold him. Yep, absolutely. Now he's attacking the triangle.
Triangle looks pretty tight, DC. I'm no Brazilian jiu-jitsu black belt, but maybe not good here.
No, it looks like it's getting in deep. Oh, nice.
Well, he's got one hand in, one hand out. Not what you're looking for defensively. And this might just be a matter of time.
Oh, no, it's posture.
Oh, full body.
Undertaker has arrived in the UFC. Oh, my goodness, a power bomb.
So just when it looked like he might get submitted, he slams his opponent down with authority as the tide turns here. Going for a submission.
Oh, he's got a choke.
He might get a finish here.
Oh, now he's in trouble.
Get choked now.
He is doing a really good job of relaxing. He's not panicking because he's getting choked. He takes his opponent to his side to try to get the finish.
Looks like his opponent's trying to turn into the choke here, but there's a lot of pressure.
Yeah, he just took the body triangle, readjust the lock, and now it looks like he's got it.
All right, full guard here, DC. What does he need to do to improve position?
Well, he's got to start to build his posture, get some damage off, move the half guard.
Oh, nice scramble by him there. Takedown defense on point. He is a master in transition. Oh, he landed a beautiful straight punch there, DC. He's got an edge in reach and certainly is making it count in this one.
Look at him chopping the wood. Chop the wood with his leg kick. He is throwing his entire hips into his body shot.
High-level striking action in that last round. Daniel, take us through it, if you will.
Tit for tat. Who has the best chin? It seemed as though they were looking for that answer. Both guys took risks. What a fantastic round.
Are you ready? Are you ready?
Fifth and final round.
Big power punch lands. Now he gets back in range.
Started to form on the right side of his body. Able to check that kick as well.
Fantastic takedown.
There's the single. Trying to pass the guard here, but a nice job by the bottom fighter defensively.
Bottom fighter did a fantastic job of following with his hips. He got his foot on the hip, and now he's throwing up a triangle attempt. He's going to try to move his left arm across to get pressure on the choke. Now he falls back into the finishing position.
side control. Upper body strength figures to be put to good use here.
Yes, absolutely. And you got to look for his opponent.
Oh, he's going for his arm now. Well, there are a few things more fun to watch in mixed martial arts than these type of transitions and scrambles on the ground.
High-level grappling can really be entertaining.
Side control now. All right, good movement by him here on the ground. He really is a master of these transitions.
He is a master of movement on the ground. You never know where he's going to be.
All right, we'll see how he chooses to defend here. All right, bottom fighter here, maybe looking to hip escape, DC. A lot of top pressure being applied here as he works out of side control. All right, so inside the open guard of his opponent. You got to be careful playing around for too long here on the ground with this guy. Might be a submission attempt here, champ.
I mean, you cannot sit in a full guard. When you sit in the full guard, you give these guys so many opportunities.
Beautiful movement, hip work on the ground here, just outstanding with the transition.
He is not staying in one place on the ground. That's very important.
Ground and pound strike is true.
He's putting him in exactly the positions he needs to be in right now. He's able to relax here, and he understands, being a veteran of so many fights, that as long as he's on top, he's winning. He feels like he's winning here. It's in there deep. There you go. Great physicality
yeah.
by this youngster.
And just when you thought he might get submitted, instead he turns defense into offense and power bombs his opponent on the canvas. All right, so there's the final horn, and what a performance by Underdog Challenger tonight. He had it all going on the feet, and in all likelihood, we've got a new champion atop this division.
If you're going to take a belt from a UFC champion, your game has to be on point. This young man came prepared mentally, he came prepared physically, and it feels like he used his striking to get the job done.
All right, the official decision is now in. Here is Bruce Buffer.
Ladies and gentlemen, after 5 rounds, we go to the judges' scorecards for a decision. All 3 judges score this contest
48-47.
For the winner by unanimous decision, and new.
Get that man a second waist, put a belt over his shoulder. He has become a 2-division UFC champion here tonight. Rarefied air. Only a select handful of guys in the history of the Ultimate Fighting Championship have won a belt in 2 divisions, and you can add his name to that list. Absolutely incredible what he accomplished in this arena here tonight.
Boom, body kick right there, landed perfect.
forever.